Mines and Money in London with James Buskard, the president of Nevada Exploration. James, thank you so much for joining us today. Tell our viewers a bit more about Nevada Exploration.
Yeah, well, thanks for having us. We've really set up the company to focus on what we think is the biggest opportunity in Nevada and certainly in the exploration space in general, and that is trying to figure out how to explore in covered settings where we can't see the bedrock. In most major jurisdictions, if it's sticking out of the ground, it's probably already been found. So rather than going after the remaining dribs and drabs, we're looking at really go after the company making tier one style deposits that we know are sitting in these covered areas, and we've chosen to focus in Nevada and for gold. And to do so, we're advancing some new exploration technology that looks at groundwater chemistry as a tool for systematically de-risking these large basins by directly following concentrations of gold in groundwater back to bedrock.
And talk to us about your land packages and your portfolio in Nevada. Tell us a little bit more about them.
Well, based on our large regional scale program, we've identified a portfolio of targets. We have three land packages currently tied up, about 40 square kilometers each. So we're one of the largest landholders in Nevada, large district scale projects that we own 100%.
Now, this is really all about creating value for areas that, as you said, are known to exist, but haven't been able to exploit by traditional methods. But so who else is doing this? I mean, is this something that is becoming more widely adopted?
Yeah, most of the majors, particularly the porphyry copper base metal guys in Australia, have formed a consortia. They're building a continental scale groundwater chemistry database. Groups like First Quantum are taking it to Africa, Botswana, Namibia, even up to Sweden. So it's really been embraced mostly by the big majors in the copper space, but in terms of gold and understanding how to apply it in this space, we're the industry leaders.
And so what are you hoping to find? What are you hoping to achieve using this type of expertise? What can we expect to really come out of this groundwater chemistry analysis?
Yeah, we've set the bar on finding big deposits. We're opening up a new search space, and the nice thing about new search spaces is that we know the low-hanging fruit are generally found first. The big deposits are found first, and then you find the smaller and smaller deposits later on in their life cycle. So in opening up a new search space, we're really going after the monsters. We're trying to find the next Cortez, the next Carlin, because we know that for every Cortez Hills that's sticking out or nearby these exposed ranges, there's another one waiting to be found in the basin. So that's what we're looking for.
And James, talk to us about the team behind Nevada Exploration. Give us an idea of the expertise and the team that you've assembled.
Yeah, well, we're all a group of longtime geoscientists based in Nevada. My colleague Wade Hodges used to run Santa Fe, the Great Basin for Santa Fe. Him and his team were involved in finding Twin Creeks and Lone Tree. I think it's 30 plus million ounces that those guys found together. So, yeah, between Wade, myself, and another colleague Ken Teller, we've got 50. Plus years of Nevada experience.
And you have the discovery experience as well. So, James, you're listed on the Venture Exchange. Where can we go to find out more about the company?
Yeah, well, we do everything we can to put what we have on our website in terms of providing some technical information, because what we're doing is quite a bit different. So we've got lots of information there. We put our news release a couple days ago with a video accompaniment that shows a bit more about the project and the context of how we're de-risking these projects. So yeah, I encourage everyone to spend some time on our website.
Excellent. We'll go check that out. Thank you so much, James. Appreciate your time.
Well, it was my pleasure. Thank you.